Hi student, today I am going to discuss the rest of the part of the chapter fun with magnet. Okay, in the previous classes we have learned about what is magnet, what are the types of magnet, what is magnetic force, magnetic effect, all this. Now today I am going to discuss how a magnet can be made from a metal piece. Okay, so making a magnet. Making a magnet. Okay, suppose here we take a iron needle or a iron bar and we take a magnet. Okay, this is a magnet. Suppose this is north pole and this one is south pole. Now first we will stroke this iron needle with this magnet taking its north polarity. Okay, that means we'll stroke this north pole and we'll start it at N1. Okay, we'll start the stroking with the north pole at N1 and then we'll go to N2. Okay, after completing this process, if we bring a magnet here, this is N1 and this is N2. So we bring this magnet with north polarity towards N1. So in this case, this N1 will repel this north pole. Because, see here, first at N1, we are stroking the north pole of this magnet with this. Okay? That means, after stroking this iron needle, will behave as a magnet. That means this iron needle will get the capacity to attract or repel other metal. That means this needle is magnetized. That means we are converting this iron needle into a magnet. And since the north pole, since the N1 is strong with the north pole, so this N1 will behave as a north pole and N2 will behave as a south pole. So N1 north pole and this is south pole. That is why if we bring the magnet with its north polarity towards N1, then there will be a repulsive force between north pole and N1. Okay? So after that, if we bring the magnet like this, south pole, north pole, that means with the south pole of the magnet towards the N1, so in this case, this N1 will attract the south pole. Because we know, north pole and north pole repel, but south pole and north pole attract each other. Okay? So in this way, an iron needle or a metal piece can be magnetized. Or we can convert a metal piece into a magnet. So this process is called single touch method. Okay? So in this process we have learned how to make a magnet. So next topic is the magnetization. Theek hai? The magnetization. So demagnetization means a magnet gradually loses its magnetic property. That means it will gradually loses its capacity to attract or repel another metal piece or iron piece. So in different way it can happen. So if we hammer a magnet, then also a magnet can lose its property. Or if it falls from a certain height, then also a magnet can lose its property. Number three, or if we increase the temperature of the magnet. Okay? If we increase the temperature of the magnet, then also a magnet can lose its property. Okay, so in the three way, polymerization can happen. Okay. Next, self demagnetization. Self demagnetization is when we left a magnet with its pole free. That means we left this pole freely in our environment, then this magnet gradually loses its property. You no need to hammer it, no need to fall from a certain height, no need to increase its temperature. Only if we keep this pole freely, okay, in our environment, then continuously this magnet will lose its magnetic property, and this is called self demagnetization. Okay, so that is why we have to keep this magnet properly, otherwise we will lose the magnet. So for that we use some material so that a magnet does not lose its property, and those material is called keeper. Okay, so how can we keep this magnet so that they can't lose its property? So suppose we have to always keep two magnets together. So this is north pole and south pole. Okay, south pole, north pole, north pole, south pole. In this way we have to keep, and between the two magnets in this region we have to place a wooden block. Wooden block, okay. And at the end here we have to keep a metal sheet. Okay, in both the end we have to keep a metal sheet, and in between the two magnets here we have to place the wooden block. Now if we keep these two magnets like this, then these two magnets will not lose its magnetic property. Okay, so next, magnetic field. So what is magnetic field? Suppose this is a magnet, okay, north pole, south pole. If we place a small iron piece here, then this magnet can attract this iron piece towards itself. Now if we place this iron piece at a very large distance from the magnet, then this magnet can't attract this metal piece because we place it very very large distance. So from this we can understood that, so in surrounding the magnet there is a region, okay, up to which only this magnet can influence its force over another material. That means if we place the iron piece here, then it can attract, but if we place the iron piece outside this region, then it can't attract. That means magnetic field is, it is the region around the magnet up to which this magnet can exert its force on another material. Okay, so this region is called magnetic field. So next, uses of magnet. So it has several uses of magnet. For example, in refrigerator door or door stopper also we can use magnet, like electric motors, speaker, microphone, in various electronic component we can use magnet. These uses are written in your book also, so study it. Thank you.